This was, God,
that rarest of all gifts, a genuine surprise. I mean, I believe it was Salvador Dali that said, it is a pity that so little of what can happen does happen.
Mm-hmm.
And this was one of those moments where it's like, not on the menu.
wasn't thinking a mustard cannon.
Nope.
out of a fire extinguisher.
All I knew was a heavy-handed concern about flames.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
That flames out.
Yeah, the flames out. I was about to say, I'm eating a raw hot dog, but they're all cooked. That's why you can eat them. Yeah.
Hey, Brent, what's happening?
Hey.
All right. Brent, what would be the most disgusting thing you could picture coming out of this?
Oh, I'm not going to answer that on the internet.
Okay, yeah, that's a good point.
But
this ranks pretty highly on that list.
you should have seen his look, the look on his face when I described what was going to happen.
How did you pitch it?
Yeah, so I was like,
first of all, how long did you withhold the information as to what was going to happen?
All the way until we were coming outside to do this. And so I told him, I said, hey, listen, we're going to have to work on some camera angles.
Right.
And I said, hey, we're going to put hot dogs out on the table.
Yep.
And he's like, that's weird, but okay.
Yep.
You know, we're going to grill some hot dogs. I need B-roll of me cooking hot dogs.
Yep.
That kind of stuff. And I said, we're going to have a couple candles on the table. Brian's been concerned about fire burns.
Yep.
So we're going to light the candles.
Which, by the way, has been super awkward because people are smoking cigars and stuff and they're ashing. And I'm like,
please don't.
Let me explain what a red flag warning is. It means all of Texas is a tinderbox.
Yep.
Yeah.
So I told him, we're going to got some candles. Brian will be concerned about the candles. And then I said, then I'm going to pull out the fire extinguisher. As you know, Brian hates fire extinguishers. Well, at least the powdered ones.
Correct.
In certain circumstances.
They make a big mess.
Unlike
this one.
So
that is
controlled, efficient.
So as it, when Brian sees me pull out a fire extinguisher, he's going to be concerned because what's happening.
Yep.
And then it's going to hose the whole table down with huge streams of mustard.
Yeah.
And the glee and pure disgusting look on his face of like, that's brilliant. That's super gross. Is that, did I sum it up pretty right?
Pretty much, yeah.
I did notice, now that we're past the moment of surprise, I noticed the little details that really shout Corey in my mind. Like, I noticed that he did this right next to where our one hose is.
You got it. 100% correct.
There was planning.
Yeah, there was planning ahead of this.
Dude, that was great. And what a good novel twist on the fill it with something weird.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah, because you fill it with water, but it's not very entertaining or visual.
Right.
You know, and then I was like, my first thought, like you said earlier, was rubbing alcohol.
Yeah.
Then I thought, that has...
That's literally a poorly made... flamethrower,
yes,
I guess.
Exactly. And I think it would have been very effective. Maybe a future episode or something.
If we're not in the middle of a red flag warning.
And we have all the safety protocols and all that
Course,
kind of stuff.
Of course, yeah.
So I thought, well, what's something that's fun? And I thought, well, mustard, because A, Brian doesn't love mustard, and I do. So,
you know, I wonder if there's some kind of version of like an elephant toothpaste or something that we could do, you know, where chemicals mix or something. I don't know. There's something here.
Yeah.
Or we could blast it and it's some substance that hardens instantly or something.
Yeah, I did think of that as well as mixing. Well, you have to be pretty good. But I thought about mixing some of that, like that foam, you know?
Yeah.
And spraying out the foam, but you'd only have like 15, 20 seconds before it really started to harden in there.
It probably, I wonder if it's the kind of thing that, I don't know.
Yeah, there's something there. There's something
there.
I think we can clear
definitely.
Out.
Definitely. Yeah. Well done, sir.
Thanks, man. Hey, you gotta go get on a podcast. Get out of here.
I gotta take a shower and get this mustard off of my face.
Yeah. Hey, thanks
for
playing
along. It's all fine. good hot dogs, though. Good hot
dogs. Oh. All right. Audio check.
Audio was fine.
Great.
However, I did learn a very terrible new smell combination today, and that is vanilla candles and some cooked hot dogs with mustard. That's horrifying. Yeah. I hope I never experience that again. Yeah. Audio is fine. Bye.
All right. Cool. we had kind of a light team today.
Yeah.
We just had Annalisa and myself.
I'm leaving, I swear.
Okay. Behind the cameras, and then Brian and Corey in front
of
the cameras.
Hey, Justin, you want a hot dog?
Yeah, dude. Justin Robert Young, ladies and gentlemen.
Justin Robert Young.
Special guest.
Like mustard. It's
like we just filmed Modern Rogue stuff. You want to eat some?
The hell is this?
So Corey's like a... Whenever Corey says, I have a surprise for you, I'm instantly at attention. And Corey's like, listen, you're going to come out, you're going to see some stuff.
Yeah.
You're going to see a couple of candles. I'm going to need you to be concerned about the candles. I'm like, well, that's easy to do because we have a red flag warning.
Yeah.
He's like, yeah, but be real concerned about the candles.
And, yeah.
You know, maybe say something about the candles.
Okay.
And I'm like, okay. And so I come out and there's a lot of hot dogs and you know, we get started and it's like, we're having some hot dogs, a lot of hot dogs. And I'm like, well, I'm concerned about the candles because that was the direction I was given. And so Corey's like, what? Why are you concerned about the candles? And so I'm like, well, I'm concerned because there's a red flag warning. And so Corey's like, you big giant baby, you worried about the candles? Let me, and he pulls out the fire extinguisher and shoots mustard all over everything. Anyway, you want a hot dog?
Yeah.
I can cook you a fresh one if you'd like a fresh one. Yeah. These are pretty cool.
No, I want OG sprayed.
All right, that's the one right there. That's...
Oh, look at that.
Make sure you get an uncooked one.
What I like the most is the coating of the mustard on the outside.
Yeah. That's how you get
it. Make sure that you don't leave any mustard to waste.
That's the Austin, Texas way.
Oh.
Local
that's
method.
That's a cold mustard cook. That's the kind of amount of mustard that makes me say, I'm glad I wore a white shirt.
I actually don't know how much is, I guess.
You actually have a little bit
on your glasses.
That's fine. Mm-hmm.
We tried to position you so you weren't actually going to get all of it in the face.
That was not lost on me. The fact that everyone was like, so anyway, naturally sit down. And when you sit down naturally, sit down right here.
Do not move.
Whenever you sit
right
down
there.
Totally naturally, sit right here.
Well, Corey carried off the test shot and it went all the way across the pond.
Yeah.
So.
It's so good.
It's raining. We're covered in mustard. And this hot dog is barely cooked. Summer has begun.
Oh my god, and there's oak stuff.
Yeah, oak there's flowers. Oak pollen flowers.
Yeah.
Oak.
God, it's
this
everywhere.
Is legitimately uncomfortable and gross.
Wow, I got more cooking.
There's a trash can over there.
It's not that weird.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Would you like some paper towels?
No, I got
okay.
I would like some self-respect.
Oh.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Good luck on the internet, friend. That was great. That was really great.
Awesome.
Smell is kind of a lot.
The smell is a lot. You got a lot of hot dog, a lot of mustard, and a lot of vanilla candle.
A lot of GoPro.
The
you
GoPro,
ever smell a GoPro?
GoPro took it.
They got a real adventurous smell.
This is definitely going on their highlight reel on the GoPro website.
Exactly.
They're like, it can withstand anything.
They're putting that shit on a GIF so it loads faster. In the middle of a wave tube, in the middle of snowboarding, mustard spray.
Exactly.
Coachella, Whistler, and the Modern Road mustard squirt.
Oh.
What else you got, Brent?
I don't know. I think that this one's pretty self-explanatory, Corey.
It is.
We put mustard in the thing and we shot the mustard out.
We did. It was successful.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for watching.
Yeah. Thanks for being here. Mm-hmm.